Let us learn about the dump truck problem. There are four components in the dump truck problem. First one is the loader queue. Here the trucks are waiting to get loaded. The second one is the loader where the truck gets loaded. Third one is the weighing queue where the trucks wait to get weighed by the scale. And last one is the scale. There can be only one truck at a scale at the time. There are four types of system states. First one is LQ of T, that is the number of trucks in the loader queue. Then there is L of T, that is the number of trucks in the loader. Then WQ of T is the number of trucks waiting in the weighing queue. And then W of T is the number of trucks being weighed by the scale. There are three event notices. First one is ALQ. ALQ is the time when the trucks arrive at the loader queue after traveling. Then EL is the end of loading time, that is the truck moves from the loader to the weighing queue, and EW is the time after the truck has been scaled and has started its traveling time. Now let us solve this problem. The question is, one company has six trucks to take ore from one site to another site of the industry. Each truck is loaded by one of the two loaders. After loading, a truck immediately moves to the weighing scale. Both loaders and scale have FIFO waiting line for service. The weighing trucks travel around and deposit ore to the industry site. Once this is done, the truck joins the loader queue. End of simulation is at 76. The distribution of loading time, weighing time and travel time are as follows. Calculate total busy time of both the loaders, total busy time of weighing scale and average loader and scale utilization. Now note that this table is uniform. It is not like your earlier problems. This is the basic explanation of how the dump truck problem works. Now initially all six trucks will be in the loader queue. Because the loader is empty, DT1 and DT2 are moved to the loaders. But since the weighing queue is also empty, DT1 moves to the weighing queue. And since one of the loaders is empty now, DT3 from the loader queue is moved into the loader. Now, we notice that the scale is also empty. So, DT1 need not wait. DT1 is moved to the scale. So, at time 0, there are 3 trucks in the loader queue, 2 trucks in the loader and 1 truck at the scale. At time 0, we have 3 trucks in the loader queue, 2 trucks in the loader, 0 trucks in the weighing queue and 1 truck at the scale. The situation in the loader queue is shown in loader queue section and the number of trucks in the weighing queue is denoted in weighing queue section. Since there are none, we have not written anything there. FEL is based on the event notices what we learnt earlier. Now let us consider the two loaders. There are two trucks in the loaders, that is DT2 and DT3. Since DT2 arrived first, we'll allot loading time to DT2 first. So we take 10 and add it with the clock. That is 10 plus 0 is 10. And we write the end loading time for DT2. Then for DT3, we take the next time 5, add it with clock 0 and write the end loading time for DT3. For DT1, since it's in the scale, we'll have to write end waiting time. That is, we take the first weighing time, add it with the clock, 0, 12 plus 0 is equal to 12 and denote it in FEL. Now we take the lowest time, the smallest time in FEL, that is 5. So next clock section starts at 5. So we'll start with the solution. At time 2, there are 3 trucks in the loader queue, 2 in the loader, 0 in the weighing queue and 1 at the scale. So condition of the loader queue is given as DT4, DT5, DT6 and in weighing queue there are none. So future event list is written as there are 2 trucks at the loader. So end loading time has to be written for those 2 trucks. So end loading time for DT2, that will be 10. And end loading time for DT3, that will be 5. And since there is DT1 at scale, you have to write end waiting time for DT1. So end waiting time for DT1 according to the table is 12. Because it started at 0 and none of the loaders and scale are busy, it is 0. Now take the minimalistic time here. So the next clock time is set 5. Now we know that DT3 has moved to the waiting queue. So DT4 will move to the loader. So we have 2 trucks at the loader queue, 2 trucks at the loader, 1 truck at the waiting queue, and 1 truck in the scale. Situation in the loader queue is that there are 2 trucks, DT5 and DT6, and in the waiting queue there is DT3. So we keep the end loading time of DT2 the same as above, and we calculate the end loading time for DT4. So for DT4, take the previous value, and for that we will have to add the next value in the loading time. So consider 5. This is what you will add with the existing value here. So EL 5 plus 5 DT4. And end waiting time of DT1 is same as above. Now to calculate this value, we take the existing current clock time minus the previous clock time into the value here, that is 2. So plus this value, that is 5 minus 0 star 2 plus 0. Here it is 5 minus 0 plus 0. Because there is only one scale, whereas there are two loaders. Now the next value is 10. Since both the values are the same, we'll consider first come first serve basis. So DT2's loading time has ended and it will enter the waiting queue. So one of the loaders is empty. So DT5 will move from the loader queue into the loader. So the number of trucks in the loader queue is 1, number of trucks in the loader is 2, number of trucks in the waiting queue is 2, and number of trucks in the scale is 1. The trucks in the loader queue are DT6 and the trucks in the waiting queue are DT3 followed by DT2. Now end loading time. We will calculate end loading time for DT5 as 10 plus next value on this loading time table, that is 10. End loading time of DT4 will remain the same. And end waiting time of DT1 will also remain the same. Now to calculate busy loading time, the same as above, 10 minus 5, 5. Into 2. That is 10 plus the older value. So it is 20. 10 minus 5 into 2 plus 10. And here it is going to be 10 minus 5 plus 5. That is 10. So the minimum value here is 10 for DT4. That is, DT4 will move into the waiting queue. That means one of the loader is empty. So DT6 from the loader queue will move into the loader. So we consider the clock time as 10. So since there are no trucks in the loader queue, the value here is 0. There are 2 trucks in the loader. Now there are three trucks in the weighing queue, that is DT3, DT2 and DT4, and one in the scale, that is DT1. Now to calculate end loading time for DT6, that is this value, previous value 10 plus next value in the loader queue, 15. End waiting time of DT1 is the same. Here, calculating busy loading time, 10 minus 10 is 0. So it is the same as above. 10 minus 10 into 2 plus 20. And here it is 10 minus 10 plus 10. Now for the next clock time, we will consider the minimum time, that is 12 over here. So we know that DT1 has finished getting weighed, so it is going to move out of the scale. So now we have to calculate arrival at the loader queue for DT1, and since the scale is empty, the first one that entered weighing queue will also be moving to the scale. So the loader queue is empty. There are two trucks at the loader, and since one of the trucks is moving out of the weighing queue, there are two trucks in the weighing queue. And there is one at the scale. Loader truck is empty. Is DT2 and DT4. The end loading time remains the same for DT5 and DT6. Since this has ended, we are going to mention end waiting time for DT3, which is in the scale now. That is plus the next value in the scale, weighing time scale. This is 12. So DT3 is 12 plus 12. And ALQ is calculated by considering the travel time as well as the clock time. So this is 60 plus 12, and load busy time is 12 minus 10 into 2 plus 20, and the scale time is 12 minus 10 plus 10, 12. So the next minimum value is 20, that is DT5 will exit the loader and enter the weighing queue. So we have 0 trucks in the loader queue. One truck in the loader, because DT5 has left the loader queue, loader, and then we have 3 in the weighing queue and 1 in the scale. So we will have DT2, DT4 and DT5. Since there is no other entry, this entry gets eliminated. So end loading time of DT5 will remain the same. End loading time of DT6 will remain the same. And end waiting time of DT3 also remains the same. And ALQ of DT1 also remains the same. Busy loading time is 20 minus 12, 2 into 2. that is 8 into 2, 16, plus 24, 40. And here it is 20 minus 12, plus 12, 8 plus 12, 20. The next minimum time is 24. 0 for loader queue. 1 in the loader. So DT3 has finished getting scaled. So it will move out of the scale. So one of the trucks in the weighing queue can enter the scale. So the next truck entering the scale is DT2. So we have DT4 and DT5 in the weighing queue. End loading time of DT6 remains the same. Here we calculate end waiting time for DT2 now. So for DT2, we will consider the next entry. 24 plus 12 for DT2. ALQ for DT1 will remain the same. Now we will calculate ALQ for DT3. So consider the next traveling time value 100 plus the current clock time 24. 100 plus 24 for DT3. Busy loading time is 24 minus 20, but here the value is 1 now. So plus the previous value. 4 plus 40, 44. For scale time, 24 minus 20 plus 20, that is 24. Now the next minimum value over here is 25. We will consider 25. Since there is no other truck entering the loader, EL time can end here. The number of trucks in the loader is 0. There are 3 trucks in the weighing queue, 1 at the scale. So that is DT4, DT5, and DT6. So end waiting time for DT2 remains the same, and ALQ for DT1 and DT3 also remains the same. So here it is 25 minus 24 plus 44, and 25 minus 24 plus 24, 45 25. The next minimum value is 36. That is DT2 will leave the scale, so ALQ of DT2 has to be calculated. And next element in the weighing queue can enter the scale. So EW of DT4 has to be calculated. The number of elements in loader queue and loader are 0. Since DT4 has left the weighing queue, there are 2 trucks in weighing queue, 1 in the scale. So DT5 and DT6 are in the weighing scale for now. Now we have to calculate end waiting time for DT4. So next value is 16. 36 plus 16 for DT4, and ALQ for DT1 and DT3 remain the same. Now we'll calculate ALQ for DT2. So consider the next value 40 plus 36. 40 plus 36 for DT2. Here it is, 36 minus 25 into 0. 36 minus 25 into 0 plus 45. So it is 45. And then 36 minus 25 plus 25. 36 minus 25 is 11. 11 plus 25 is 36. Minimum value is 36 plus 16, that is 52. 52. Since there are no trucks in the loader queue as well as the loader, it is 0. Now DT4 has exited the scale. So since it has exited the scale, the next value to enter the scale will be DT5. So there is one truck in the weighing queue, one truck in the scale. DT6 is in the weighing queue. Now to calculate end waiting time for DT5, take 52 plus the next value 12 for DT5. Now ALQ for rest of the trucks remain the same. And now we will calculate ALQ for DT4. That is 40 plus current clock time 52 for DT5. Oh, sorry, for DT4. Busy loading time is given as 52 minus 36 into 0 plus 45, that is 45, and scale time is 52 minus 36 plus 36, that is 16 plus 36, 52. Now next minimum time is 64. So taking that into consideration, the number of trucks in the loader queue 0, loader 0. So DT5 is exiting the scale and DT6 can enter the scale. So the number of trucks in the weighing queue also becomes 0. Since DT6 is entering the scale, there is 1 in the scale, that is DT6. So there is no truck in the loader queue as well as the weighing queue. Now we will calculate end waiting time for DT6. 64 plus 16, that is for DT6. Now we will keep ALQ of rest of the trucks the same and calculate ALQ for DT5.
So ALQ4 DT5 is given as 80 plus 64, that is 4 DT5. Busy loading time is 64 minus 52 into 0 plus 45. And 64 minus 52 plus 52, that is 64. The next minimum time over here is 72. That means DT1 has arrived at the loader queue. But since loader queue is empty and even loader is empty, it can directly go to the loader instead of waiting at the loader queue. So at time 72, there is one truck at the loader, that is DT1, 0 in the weighing queue and 1 at the scale, that is DT6. We have to calculate end loading time for DT1 now, that is current clock time plus the time in the table, that is 10 plus 72 for DT1. Rest of the values are the same. Is 124 for DT3, ALQ 76 for DT2, ALQ is 92 for DT4. And the ALQ is 144 for DT5. End waiting time of DT6 is 80. Now busy loading time is 72 minus 64 into 0 plus 45. That is 45. 72 minus 64. Plus 64, that is 8 plus 64 is 72. Now note that the minimum time is 76, so we will be stopping our operation at this time. So since there is one loader free, DT2 is not going to wait at the loader queue, so the number of trucks in the loader queue is 0. There are going to be two trucks at the loader now. The number of trucks in the weighing queue are also 0, and the number of trucks in the scale is 1 since DT6 is getting weighed. The number of trucks in the loader queue and weighing queue are nil. So we have to calculate end loading time for DT2 now. So we will calculate the last value in this table and the current clock time, that is 76 plus 10 for DT2, and rest of the values are the same. So if we consider the previous table, here the value was 1. So when we calculate this, it is 76 minus 72 into 1 plus the previous value 45, that is 4. Plus 45, 49, and then 76 minus 72 plus 72. That is 76. So we stop the operation here. Has to calculate four parameters. First one is total busy time of loader. That is nothing but BL. That is this value. 49 minutes. And total busy time of scale, total busy time of scale is 76 minutes. Average loader utilization is given by the formula BL divided by 2, the whole divided by total execution time. So we know that BL is 49 minutes divided by 2, whole divided by 76. That is the clock time. Total execution time is this time. That is equal to 0.382. Average scale utilization is given by the formula BS divided by total execution time. That is 76 divided by 76, which is equal to 1.